This is the Pazuzu Algarad you know.
How did we not know? That's what people, you know, how did the neighbors not smell anything?
The so-called devil worshiper, addict, murderer who left the bodies of two men to rot in his backyard in Clemmons.
He would eat the heart of it and then burn the flesh of the rabbit.
This is John Alexander Lawson. He and Pazuzu are different, but the same, because they're the same person.
Little Johnny was not right, and everybody knew it.
John Alexander Lawson was born in San Francisco, California in December of 1978, raised primarily by his mother, Cynthia, who took pictures of her baby in the bathtub, smiling with his straight blonde hair and piercing blue eyes, dressed up like a cowboy, hat and all.
Well, he was in the Cub Scouts, and I was the den leader.
Cynthia was raised in Forsyth County. Having graduated from Parkland High School, the pair moved back to North Carolina when John was two. For years, they were a normal family. He was a normal boy, with his blue Royals jersey and bat on his knee.
And then he got into football.
In pads for the Pofftown Packers, golden locks flowing in the wind.
And he just kind of, no more sports.
Cynthia says she first noticed a change in her son when she remarried. The pair and his new stepfather, Johnny, moved into the home on Knob Hill Drive in Clemmons. But John and Johnny didn't always get along, and John became a recluse.
I told Johnny that I wanted to just maybe I can work with him.
The couple separated, and neighbors say that's when they started seeing John outside again.
And we had so much fun. I mean, he always made me laugh.
Where he was rarely seen was at school.
2008, when it was really obvious that he had changed.
He'd repeated second grade and ninth when he dropped out.
Yeah, and that's basically because he didn't go to school. It wasn't because he failed, he just didn't go to school.
His appearance shifted. The long locks were shaved off. His dress became more gothic.
He was wanting to hang out with people that I didn't want him to hang out with.
She brought him to what was then the Reynolds Health Center on Highland Avenue, but he wasn't there long.
I think that I loved him too much, and then, you know, I said, okay, whatever you want to do.
Then he started searching for ways to change how he saw the world, with a forensic evaluation showing he started regularly consuming alcohol at age 13.
There was this one guy that was doing meth and got John in to doing that, and I don't know if I just turned a blind eye or...
Soon, he further changed the way the world saw him. He legally changed his name from John Lawson to Pazuzu Algarad. Pazuzu, a demon featured in The Exorcist. Cynthia says he didn't worship the devil, instead, a dragon, as she put it, named Tiamat. Homemade tattoos on his face developed from this, to this, to this. He filed his teeth to points.
But that was one of the first ones he did, and you can just see the anger coming out.
In February of 2006, at the age of 27, Pazuzu went to Daymark Recovery Services. Records show he was diagnosed with agoraphobia, an anxiety disorder centered around fearing or avoiding places that might cause you to feel panic. He left after 2 months, then returned again in October of 2008. Within the next year is when Cynthia says she was in the home as Pazuzu and his spiritual wife, Amber Birch, killed Joshua Wetzler and Tommy Dean Welch.
I went back to my bedroom. I thought, what am I going to do? Okay. Well, gosh, in the state he's in, he might shoot me. I don't think he would. He's had plenty of opportunities to kill me if he wanted to.